It's NinjaBlobC today, and I'm gonna give you a clay tutorial video, which probably is gonna fail. So, I've got a lot of clay tools. And I'm going to be making a lot of summer clay charms, if they work. So I'm going to start with a little bunny clay charm that's going to be holding a little ring. I've done one of these before. I'll just get it out. So there it is. There's a little bunny clay thing. It's got pink sunglasses with a blue ring and a little smiley face. No, that's not going to focus. This time I'm going to make it with pink and blue for the ring and red sunglasses. So yeah. So first of all, you're going to need a bowl for the body, and I'm going to get a little more clay because I don't have that much white left. That's clean. All my clay's really dirty. And then you're just going to want to roll that into a bowl. So there you go, there's my little clay ball, and you're going to want to squish it down a bit onto a surface just so that it has a flat bottom so it can stand up, and you might want to flatten off the top a little bit too so that the head can go on it. Now you're going to need even more white clay. So I've made this other white ball, and it's, you know, it's about the size, just a little bit smaller than the body, and I'm just going to want to pop it on top. Like that. I'm going to try and roll it out a little bit so it's to the shape that I want it. Now it looks like a snowman. So now you're going to want to make the ears with even more white. So I've just got a bit of white, I'm going to split in two, I'm probably going to need more than this. I'm just going to roll it like that. Till it's kind of like this shape, I'm going to need a little less. And there you go, there's one ear done. And then I'm going to do the next one. You're going to want to squish it down a bit just so that it looks more like an ear. And there you go. That's how it's looking so far. Next we're going to make the tail. And you don't need too much white for this, you just need a little bit, like that. And I'm going to roll it into a ball. Ooh, I like this song. And then you stick this on. Okay, so next I think we're going to make the hands and the legs. So I'm going to take a little bit of white, a bit more, and roll it into a sausage shape. And then just put it on right under the neck, like that. I think I'm going to need a little bit more. And then the other one's going to need to hold the ring, so I'm going to make it holding its arm out. You may notice this clay looks extremely mucky. I'm sure you'll find some way to make it look less dusty. So I'm going to have it like that. And then the feet, you don't have to do the feet because they don't really show up that well. But if you want to, then you just take a tiny little bit of clay and roll it into a ball and stick it on the bottom like that and that. There we go. And now I'm gonna make the face. So all you need for the face is a bit of black clay and roll it into a tiny little ball, and I like flattening it out a tiny little bit. You just gotta stick it on like that, and get a tiny bit more clay and roll it into a very thin little line thing. And with caution, you can use a tool, which is easier sometimes, but I like to use my nails because they're accurate. Sometimes I will put it like on my nail so that I can bend it like that. Yeah, I think that's a little too much, so I'm gonna cut a bit off. I'm gonna bend it around my nail again. Will do. And then you just stick it on. This can be really difficult, so just take some time. It may take some practice. And then for the other eye, it's just the same. You roll it into a ball, flatten it down a bit, and stick it on. That's a bit too big. Yeah. I like listening to music while I'm doing this, just because it takes my mind off all the pressure of actually doing it right. So I'm just gonna stick this on. That's wonky. There. I think that's good enough. I think this one, the mouth was a little too thick, so this time I've made it a little thinner. And now I'm going to make the sunglasses. So what you need is a bit of whatever colour you want. I'm using red. And you need not too much. I've just got a big chunk out. And you need to roll it like this. Excuse me. And just roll it into a very thin sausage-like shape. And then I'm going to cut how much I want on the top. On this one I don't use too much, it just needs to go across the head. So I'm going to get this cutting tool and just cut about that much. So I'll cut that much, that might be a little too much. No, that looks alright. Might cut off the end so that it looks flat like the other bit. You may want to try and just make the edges softer if you cut this. You can also use a blade and other tools. I'm using just a rubber one. Oh no, I broke it. Hold on. Perfectly fixed, it's fine. I never did anything. You saw nothing. Okay, so I'm going to now get some of this and just put it on there. And put it to how big I will want the sunglasses. You don't want it too big, otherwise it'll cover its face. And I'm gonna cut that. Difficulties. There we go. And then cut a bit more off for the other loop. There we are. So it now looks like a B, like the letter, not the bumblebee. And that will go on there like that. Now at the moment it kind of looks like a school rabbit, which is actually quite cute. So if you want, you can make it into a school rabbit and, you know, have it holding a book or something, which I'm probably going to do at some point. But I'm going to make these into sunglasses by adding some black into the middle. So I'm going to take off a bit of black and take it off. Oops. Roll it into a ball and just try and fit it into the actual sunglasses bit. Flatten it out as well. This black's gone really hard. It's not soft. There we go. That's in there. I think I'm gonna fill it up a bit more. To be honest, what you can do is just roll it out like this and just put it all over the back, which would actually be a better idea than what I'm doing. No, I can't bother. Which will cover the back, and then you can flip the glasses over so that it's just what you need. Turn this over, and there you go. So it's like that. I'm going to try and edge this bit out because it looks kind of sharp. And flatten it. I need a little bit more black to fill it up. This can take time and practice, so I'm sorry I'm taking a long time. There we go, I think that'll do. I'm sure the ones that you make will be a lot better. I think the ones on here went better. These ones are quite big. Oh no! So now I think we're going to move on to the ring. You may want to add a little bit of white onto it just to make it look like it's shining, but I always coat it in glossy stuff, so I don't really need to do that. I'm using blue. Wait, am I? Am I using blue? No, I'm using pink. I'm using pink. Don't listen to me. Okay, so I'm using pink for the base of the ring, and I'm going to use the blue for the out. For the pattern. Oh dear. And then you just need to roll this. I'm gonna make it soft first because it's really hard. Okay, so I've rolled this into a little sausage kind of thing, and it's now raining outside. That's so gloomy. Give me a moment. It's been like 1 minute and it's almost stopped raining. So, I've made this into a sausage shape, and now I just need to put it into a ring. Like that. Gonna alter the shape. So it can be like that. You can do different things, not just rings. You can do it holding a float or maybe even a lollipop if you want. But I quite like the ring idea because it goes around its arm sometimes, if you're lucky. Oh dear. You've just got to keep trying to squish it together. That's what it's looking like so far. I'm trying to flatten out this little bit where it's connecting. Oh no, it's I. There we go. I think I'm gonna need to try and squash this. This is so difficult. Hold on. It's raining again. Okay, so whoa. That's a lot of rain. It's gonna start like thundering soon or something. I had to try and redo the ring so that it would actually work. But it's turned out okay, so you can now stick that on if you want. Or you might want to wait and put on the pattern, which I'm going to do. So I'm going to get my blue. Move some of this stuff out of the way. Okay, so I'm going to get a bit of blue and roll it like this. With this one, I had to try and mix in a bit of white to try and make it a lighter blue. So you may want to mix some colours to try and make them lighter or darker. I suggest if you're trying to make stuff darker, do not put black in it. Don't. That's too much blue. You don't have to do a wavy line, actually. I think I'm going to do something else this time. I'm going to try and do some flowers because they can look quite nice. So you're just going to want to make a few blobs and stick them all together. Something seriously wrong with this song. I don't understand it. Oh, it's stopped raining now. Okay. The weather's weird. You may not want to do flowers because they're pretty hard. There we are, there's one flower at least. Oh no, it's this song again. We used to sing this all the time in our school. Ugh. I think I prefer wavy lines. So you've just got to decide what kind of pattern you like. You may want to do stripes or dots, polka dots, something like that, but I quite like the wavy line. It's quite simple to do. All you need to do is lay it down on the ring and just wave it around. Never underestimate how much clay you need just to get up next to you. So I've completed the ring. I tried to do wavy, but it didn't go very well and I couldn't take it off, so I decided to do this. And seeing as that doesn't look great, I'm going to try and make it into sort of a little dinosaur thing. If you've seen one of those things. I don't have one myself because I can swim. Yay! So I roll this up. And then you can stick it like that, I guess. I've shaped it like this. That doesn't look very good. Screw it. Trying to think of what else I could do with it. There we are. I'm gonna try and roll this pink up. Okay, so I made it look like this because the head thing, you can tell it wasn't going well. So, it looks like this. It looks pretty cute. I had to reposition the arm so that it actually went around the arm. So, I guess we're finished with that. It looks a lot chubbier than this one, but that looks kind of cute. So, you may have to try this a couple times. Luckily for me, this one didn't go badly. So next, we're on to a little sun.
Oh!
Don't you want me? Oh! Just in a cocktail bar. So you're gonna need some yellow. And all you need to do with this is roll it into a ball. I think I might have too much, but I'm just gonna try it anyway. Whilst I'm rolling it, I just thought of another thing you could make the rabbit hold, which is you could make it hold a little bottle of sun cream, and you could put a tiny little sun on it, and it would look really cute. So here's my ball, and I'm just lightly flattening it out slightly, so it's like that. And oh, I forgot something. Look how many hooks I have. So with zines, they're pretty helpful, and this is a pretty nice jar. I'm going to reposition this. It basically, you just turn this thing, and you can choose which peggy thing you want. With this rabbit, I'm not sure which one would go as well. Focus. I think a silver one would go quite nicely because the gold doesn't really match anything. I'm thinking of a darker silver though and not a light silver, simply because a light silver, it would look too much like it. So I'm just gonna put this... Hold on. There you go. There we are. Okay, so moving back to the sun. I've done this, and now I'm going to get a bit of orange. Oh, goodness. No one wants to listen about cancer whilst we're doing the video. It's very gloomy. So I'm going to roll this up just so it softens out, because it's quite hard at the moment. And I'm just going to take little pieces off like this. And I'm going to try and shape them into little triangles, which can make little sort of beams on the sun. You've all seen them before. I'm gonna just, shape it with my fingers. You don't want it to be really pointy because that doesn't give it a bubbly sort of look, and bubbly looks really nice. So that's kind of big, but it looks alright to me. So you just need to do lots and lots of these. I looked at you as a bell, and now you're in my mouth. And this is crazy. Here's my number. So come you me. So this is what my sun looks like. I may have done a few too many triangles. But now I'm going to move on to the face. You can put sunglasses on it if you want to, but I just prefer putting a little face on it, because otherwise the sun will be protecting itself from itself. Makes so much sense. So just do the same with the rabbit. You just need to squash this up, and I'm going to roll it into more of a ball. think that might be a bit too big. Then I'm going to do another one. Then I need to do a little mouth like the last one, and the mouths are always the trickiest. So there's my little face on the sun. Now we need one of these things. I think I'm going to use another silver, because if I use gold, then it will kind of clash with the stuff. I'm not really sure where to put it, because I kind of put it on the wrong angle where this bit is pointing straight up, so there's not really any place to put it. But I think I'm going to use a light silver, and you just need to put it in. Somewhere. Try put it in this spike. That was a bad idea. There we are. So I've got it looking like that, and that looks alright. So I guess we're moving on to the next one, which will be a watermelon. Alright. So with watermelon, you're obviously going to need red, and green, and white. So I'm going to start with the green, because that's the... I'm going to start with the red, because that's the... in a bit. And you just need a big chunk of red. And I'm going to take this hair off. Yeah. So now you just need to... I'm going to soften it out a bit because it's quite hard at the moment. And then you just need to shape it into a triangle shape. And remember not to use sharp corners because then it doesn't look as bubbly. You don't want the clay too thin, because otherwise it'll look kind of weird. And you need a curved top, so it's like that. And I'm just gonna kind of roll it out like this, so it looks a little curved. So there we are. I think that's pretty good. I might want a bit more space so I can put a face on it. And now I'm going to use some translucent clay, not transparent, because that gives it quite a nice sort of crystal effect. It keeps sounding Australian. So you just want to take a bit and try and roll it out and flatten it like that, and you just want to lay it on top. I'm trying to get this right. You need it to fit on, so roll it out, squash it. All my translucent clay looks red for some reason. I think it was when my friend came around and she was using red, and then she was using the white, so... you don't have to use translucent clay. It just gives it quite a nice effect. if you have translucent clay, I would recommend using all of translucent clay for this, because then all of it looks crystal, but I only have white, so I'm just going to use white. Okay, and then we're moving on to the green. And you just take off a bit. That's quite a bit. And then you roll it up. As you can tell, that's way too much. It needs to be thicker than the white, which is just quite a thin layer. So I'm going to try and shape it into the correct thing that I want it to look like. That's too much. I'm going to actually use my cutting tool at the moment. Wherever it is, here it is. Oh dear. Shouldn't have done that. I'm going to use my nail. See, a lot of people use a blade, but I'm not allowed to use a blade. So, at the moment it looks like this. I think it looks better on the other side. Hold on. Just like that, because this side has a lot of white on it. But that's how it looks at the moment. It looks alright, it's not too bad. I'm gonna add a little bit of white to here. Okay. And then we're going to use some black to put some seeds on, which I almost forgot. Yeah? Okay, so I'm back, sorry about that. And I'm making the little seeds. So just gonna roll that up and put it like that. Yeah, that's a bit too big. You need to get it the right size because you still gotta put a face on it. I would actually recommend putting on the face first, but I can't bother to do that at the moment. So I'm just going to put it on the tip, because, like I said, you have a face. Yeah. And then a tiny bit more black. Put that on. My fingers are pretty mucky at the moment because I've been doing so much clay. So now I'm going to do the face. You can do a different face, which I'm actually going to do. I'm going to do one of the sort of cat faces. That's way too small. So excited to see them. Oh. Well, just, I suddenly thought it deleted all my video that I just did. So I'm just putting on the next eye. And then I need more black. So I'm gonna roll this black up into a little message. There we are. Oh no, a cat. To make the cat mouth, there's two ways of doing it. You could do two pieces of black, which I'm going to do because it's easier, or you can try and do it all in one go, and I just can't do that because I'm not as pro as that yet. Okay, so you just gotta make two mouths, basically, and then put them together. This isn't going well. Why so blurry? Okay, I'll put a bit of mouth on the next bit. There we go, I tried. It's really blurry again. That's my little watermelon. Oh my goodness, what is wrong with my voice? That's my little watermelon. And then you just gotta get thingy-ma-bobby. What do you call it? Hook. That's it. I don't know whether I should do gold on this. I think gold would look quite nice, actually. Okay, so I'm gonna get a gold. I'm just gonna stick it in the top. Squish it like that. There we go. So I've made a little watermelon. This is how it's going so far. Watermelon. Rabbit. And the sun. The watermelon seeds have suddenly become squashed, so I'm gonna have to sort that out. Okay, so next, I think I'm gonna move on to this little thing I saw online, which looked really cute, and it was like a bit of sand with a starfish on it and the water next to it. So this is probably gonna feel really bad. I didn't have any sand-coloured clay. So I had to use glow-in-the-dark clay, because it looks a little bit sand-coloured. No. So I'm going to get out my sand-coloured clay stuff. Okay, so I rolled it into a ball, and I squished it out, and this is my sand. So I'm actually going to try and give it a texture. You can use actually a toothbrush for this, and they work quite well, but I don't have any old toothbrushes to use, because who keeps old toothbrushes? So I'm going to use this little tool and just stab it a load of times. Okay, so this looks kind of weird. It looks like cheese. I'm hoping it's not going to look so bad when I put the water on it. But like I said, it works best with a toothbrush. So next I'm going to do the water. And I'm going to see if I have any lighter water. Okay, I don't have any lighter blue, so I might have to mix this, but I really can't be bothered to mix it, so I don't know what to do. What should I do? I think I might paint this afterwards. So you can paint the clay if it's not the right colour, and you can't be bothered to mix anything, which I'm probably going to do. So I'm just going to get this clay, and I'm going to roll it out to soften it, and then squish it. So it looks like that. I'm going to try and make it a bit wavy by pushing my nail into it. You can also use clay tools. There we are. I think I might need to flatten it a bit. Yeah. So then if you have translucent or even transparent, because I think transparent would work better for this clay, then you can get tiny little balls
and roll them up, and then just try and make them a bit square maybe, and just put them on like that. I think square looks better, and that'll sort of make it look like it's splashing against the sea, so it just gives it a nice effect. I'll be back. Okay, so I've finally finished this. It looks kind of weird on the camera, but it looks better in real life. I'm gonna try and make the sand look less cheesy. Okay, so I used a different tool, which is this. And I just had to lay that down, so it looks a bit better. And now I need to make a sea star. So I think I'm going to use pink, because that's quite a nice colour for a sea star. You can also use a seashell, which would look quite nice. So I'm going to squish down a bit of pink. And I'm not even going to try and use different parts. I'm just going to try and shape it into a star. And you mean, once again, you need to make sure you don't make the sides too sharp, because that will make it lose its bubbly effect. Four sides and I need one more. Okay, that's good. It's really hard. Looks like Patrick at the moment. No, that looks way too big. Okay, I'm gonna... So I made my star and I found out you kind of have to do each side individually, because otherwise it's really tricky and it just doesn't look as good. So it looks kind of wrinkly at the moment. I kind of rushed it. But I'm going to put a tiny little face on the sea star so that it looks cute. So you're going to need even tinier pieces because the sea star looks so small unless you make the sea star bigger and the whole thing bigger. It's all sticking to me. I have really sticky fingers at the moment. There we go.
Heard of, like Bobobot77, who wants to hang out. So I tell him where I live.
Okay, so now I'm gonna try and put one of the charm things. It looks kind of weird at the bottom, but no one's gonna know. I'm gonna try put the peg, I don't know, hook thing in. I don't know what color to have. Would silver or gold be better? I think gold. I'm gonna use that gold. That gold looks nice. That didn't go well. If I get a bit of blue, just stick it over. Okay, so did I have anything else? I don't know. Well, if I ever think of some more summer things for you to do, like pineapples and stuff like that, then I will do another video on clay. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll be back again soon. So, bye!